Now your microclimate forecast, presented by Bill Howe. Here's meteorologist Carlene Chavis.
Our temperatures may have gone down a little, but it feels like that humidity is coming up.
Yeah, it is.
Getting a little sticky out there, Carlene.
So you like that, huh?
No. Yeah. I came here for a reason. I love that humidity in Florida.
Following you.
It really is. No, you can feel it outside. Yeah, it's a little dewy. Yeah. It's just that humidity is increasing. And what we're talking about in the week ahead is that humidity increasing over the mountains, and that's going to lead to monsoonal moisture and even the potential for some thunderstorms. Mm-hmm. So now we get a mixed bag of everything once again. So we're talking about cooler temperatures right now. We are sliding into the middle of the work week, now into the end of the work week. Days ahead, temperatures will continue to dip, but they will increase by next week, and that will bring in more monsoonal moisture as well. Let's go ahead and take a look at this view. I can't get over it. It's absolutely beautiful. Looking south from Otay Mountain, you have the nice moon out there. It was a full moon yesterday, full thunder moon, and we're still seeing some of the cloud cover just moving along the mountains, and we'll continue to see that west of the mountains as we go into the overnight hours. For downtown, cloudy skies, 66 degrees. Also, winds out of the south southwest at 5 miles per hour. Relative humidity is at 84%. We will continue to have the cloud cover sticking around, even the potential for some patchy fog into the overnight hours for the inland valleys. Right now, we're seeing a little bit of that reduction in visibility. 6 miles for Carlsbad, 8 for Oceanside, also at 8 in Imperial Beach. Kearny Mesa is at 9. Across the county and across the country, I should say, we are talking about quite a different story. So we're nice and dry out west, mostly dry conditions, a few showers for the Pacific Northwest, but we are seeing some heavier pockets of rainfall into the overnight hours continuing for the Dakotas, also the potential for some severe thunderstorms into the overnight hours. The last bit of moisture associated with what was Hurricane Barry when it moved on shore last Saturday for Louisiana is raining itself out right along the eastern seaboard and will continue to do so into the overnight hours. We have a trough of low pressure that's brought the cool down, so we had very warm temperatures, very hot as we started off the work week. Now we're backing off, and that will continue all the way until Friday. But a ridge of high pressure will build in, and as that happens, a much bigger warm-up is in store for us by next week, and tapping into monsoonal moisture, bringing in a chance we could see some isolated showers over the mountains. There is a moderate risk of rip currents at our local beaches. Also keep in mind a southwest swell for tomorrow, about 2 to 4 feet with our wave height. We'll be in the low 70s, and we'll take that into the weekend for the coast. Also talking about the 80s, 90s will return for the inland valleys by next week. So it's good to be west of the mountains over the next couple of days because there is a slight chance of showers and thunderstorms and much warmer temperatures for the mountains. But at least the desert's not in the 110s next week. So around 107, not
so bad. So everyone's getting a little break, relatively speaking.
It's pretty nice out there.
Okay.
We'll enjoy it.
Thanks, Carlene.
Welcome.